Okay, in this video, I'm going to try to show you guys how I do an edge like this on something like this. Now, there's already a bunch of steps, and roughing this out with a hammer stone, I'm not very good at it, so it looks pretty ugly. Hopefully, I'll have enough time in you know, 8 or 9 minutes to show you how I thin the edge down that thin. First, what I do, of course, is look to see if it needs to be abraded at all. Where do I need to take flakes off? And I need to take some of this mass off here. I'm going to sharpen this tip end. All I'm doing now is I'm lowering the edge so I can send a flake across and get rid of this mass here. I lost some of the tip there, but it's okay. I got room to work with. My preforms are this size. Okay. So I can prepare this edge simply by beveling. You notice it's not perfect. There's a little lump right here. But I can hit on the side of it, right in there, and hit in toward that ridge. You can hit where it's humped up, like Paleo Man Jim says. Right there's a little hump. You can hit there, but it's going to take a lot more force to remove that. So I'm going to go right beside it. And when you're on the tip, you have to be aware that a lot of force might snap it off. Otherwise, it wouldn't matter too much. That was okay, but it's a little bit too shallow. I'm going to abrade just by brushing. And brushing, it abrades and causes it to bevel a little bit. I'm going to hit right there, right here on this point. It's a little bit of an odd ridge, but we'll see. Now, if you take your time on these, you're going to have better flakes. I tend to get impatient and just go to town on it. But for better results, take your time, plan where you're going to hit. Keep it very clean. And down the road, when you're coming down to the finished product, you don't have to clean up as much. So I'm going to quickly thin down this tip and put a thin edge on it. I'm just brushing, just beveling. I think an argument can be made that a lot of real artifacts were made in this way, with a hammer stone beveling the edge just by brushing flakes with no grinding. No grinding this way. It does grind a little bit this way, but not much. And all I'm doing is just barely touching it to create bevels of the correct angle. I can hit either side. Now, if it crushes, I'll have to abrade it. Yeah, it did crush, so The beveling isn't sufficient. Try one more time. That wasn't too bad. But on heat-treated stone, I think I'm going to have to abrade a little bit. Turn this edge. That wasn't too good. A little bit too aggressive. As a beginner, this is going to be difficult to control. I've been working at it for several years now, and it's still difficult for me to control the direct percussion. See, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to have to take off that mass. I'm going to cut across from the other side. So I usually just grind the entire edge, and like in the previous video, it knocks off the weak spots because it isn't perfectly flat. It's rounded and it follows the contours. And now I can hit all the way down. On either side, either way. And I'll work either side. I know that some guys will turn the edge and they'll only work one side with a series of flakes. Then flip it over, turn the edge, and send some more flakes across. But that's not... I don't do it that way because... that's too methodical for me. I'll just take flakes opportunistically from either side. And I think some of the actual artifacts were done in a very methodical, very precise, very step-by-step way, but the ones that I've seen, the vast majority that I've seen, were done in a pretty much a random style. See, the edge is already getting pretty thin. It's still fat in the middle, but the edge is getting thin. I'm going to switch over to a smaller diameter. And what I'm doing is I'm just barely catching the hard spots. There's not many left. There's one here. I can take that off. And I'm being a little bit aggressive. Because I want those flakes to go inward, and I'm not too concerned about steps. I'm just concerned about making that edge thin. And you know, you can make it as straight as you can too. That helps. But the critical thing is to get the edge suitable for cutting. Because that's the advantage of the stone point. It has a cutting edge. Not just a hard point to penetrate, but an edge to cut. And in the beginning, this is going to be difficult. It was for me to get that artifact type edge, and not the modern edge that you see on so many points. You can see how it's already getting thin on the edge itself. In the middle is still fat, but on the edge itself it's getting thin. And the flakes I'm taking off, the bubble of percussion is concave, and it's just slightly concave just beyond that edge. just beyond and slightly concave, and that's what makes it thin. And just be very careful, you look down for more spots to hit. I started sharpening it before I took the flake I was supposed to take off to try to clear this up here. So I'm just gonna leave it at that. We're at 10 and a half minutes anyway. And I'll go into depth more on sharpening as I do some future videos on more advanced techniques. But I hope you get the idea.